Well, the day is almost here. Mike just mentioned it. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for many Americans will appear in the sky this Monday. Thousands have been already flocking to states like Texas that are in the path of totality for the upcoming total solar eclipse. We've seen hotels and Airbnbs booked years in advance. Eclipse chasers say it's pretty easy to understand why.
This is a huge deal. The astronomy world has been preparing for this for the last 7 years. One of the simplest and most incredible things is happening in our solar system.
The total eclipse will be visible within a 115-mile wide path. It begins in New Mexico. You see that there toward the bottom of your screen and ends over Canada. States like Texas, Arkansas, Indiana, New York, Maine, New York, as Mike just mentioned, they will all be in that path of totality. California will get a partial eclipse. So in our region, that starts at 10 a.m. Monday morning. So about 10:16, the max eclipse is set for 11:15, and it'll end just after noon.
All right, let's go now to meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn with more eclipse excitement. What we can expect weather-wise on that day.
And that's important because if you want to get good viewing, you want to have clear skies. So let's take a look at what the forecast has in store for folks along that line of totality that's going to be taking place. You can see it cutting across the United States. Starting in Texas at around 11:30 a.m., we are looking at some areas of rain. Look at that. We have cloud cover and rain stretching from the border to San Antonio. The shadow is moving. You ever know how fast the shadow moves when you have an eclipse going along? Well, it's going to be starting out at 1,600 miles an hour as it makes its way across Texas. It's going to be zooming past Dallas quickly with cloudy skies expected in that area. We're going to keep the clouds through Arkansas where it's going to actually increase in speed up to 1,700 miles an hour. It's going to be zooming as it makes its way across Indianapolis, the Indianapolis 500 going on. It's up to 2,000 miles per hour. That shadow is going to be ripping through Indiana, but the weather's looking better. They're going to be kind of on the edge of some clouds, so you may actually get some pretty good viewing in Indiana. Ohio, not too bad around Cleveland, also maybe just a few clouds. So there should be decent viewing in Cleveland as it continues on into New York. Buffalo, surprisingly, looking pretty good. Cloud cover, though, starts to increase as you make your way past Syracuse and Watertown. But then you get into Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine, and we're looking at clearing skies. So should be great viewing in those locations. And that's where the shadow really picks up speed. It's going to be moving along at 3,000 miles per hour. So that's what's going on with the eclipse and the weather. Now back over to you.
I love when he breaks out the toys.
Yeah.
He gets to use all
Professor
the toys. Thank you so much, Dirk. Stay with us as we follow the excitement leading up to the eclipse on the KCRA3 app. We have special coverage Monday morning as well. Now, again, Tamara, this is one of those things, even though we're not going to get the full eclipse out here, you're still going to get the glasses.
Mm-hmm. You do.
You still don't look up at the sun.
Are we going to be provided glasses? I mean, we'll be here at 10 a.m. on Monday.
Right. I don't know. That was something we need to ask
our
boss. Question about higher ups.
Yeah. Here's the deal. Sure. Back in 2017, I covered it out at Sac State, so I still have those glasses. I'm a pack
we
rat.
Might just need to borrow.
We might have to
share.
You
get a second, I get a second, Mike's going to, we all just got
the other thing, too, we reported there's an eyeglass place. I think it's Warby Parker, and again,
that's a paid
sponsor for them,
sure.
But they are handing out one per person. So if you go in there with the kids,
there you go.
Go grab some of the glasses that you need.
Right.